And so next question is kind of what can we see in the addition region, like in Sweden and where our individual examples meet. So this is an SEM of the interface, the one tooth and the two tooth, or this is really one of them. And through EDS, you can actually get the composition of these, where this is the calcium content and this is the phosphorus content. And so you can see what that is actually to the lung section of our samples. So far, we've been focusing on just the increase of mineral content and creating a more mechanically robust interface. But there's also a lot of growth factors and creating the growth factors going on along with extracellular matrix proteins. And this turns into a really complex system. So instead of trying to look at all of this at once, we really want a simple platform which we can modulate the material stiffness and control the degree of immobilized biomolecules, and then look at either signaling pathways, gene expression, or proliferation data, essentially cellular responses of our cells or stem cells, using stiffness and biomolecular molecular targeting independent of one another. So that's what we want to do with this tool. So now, so the first part is similar. So, in order to get a correct cellular response, the entire application is essentially to do this in vivo. We can't just add our growth factor to the media, we need to mobilize it onto our scaffold so that it stays relevant in the body. So, in order to do this, we can use endosomal photolithography to pattern our biomolecules onto our substrate. So, we can decentralize the collagen gel scaffold with endosomal, and then you essentially expose it in the presence of your biomolecule that you want to pattern to a UV laser, which creates a bond between the endosomal and the biomolecules. It walks through if it doesn't create a bond, so you can actually create multiple layers, and the endosomal photolithography is time-sensitive. So essentially, this whole cartoon will summarize what happens in the scaffold, you shine it with UV laser, and you get biomolecular catches. So we've shown that we can pattern PDGF, which is a proliferation growth factor, at different concentrations, at different mobilization rates, depending on exposure time to the UV laser. We've also shown that through a common cross-section method, we can control the OX modules of our subject simply by changing the ratio of GF to NHF to our collagen scaffold. So these boosting ratios are the ones we will proceed with, since they have specifically different electric modules. So our next question is going to be to the manipulation of stiffness and the manipulation of the factor mobilization are actually truly independent of the product. So the UV exposure does not either degrade or affect the cross-linked collagen, so that is independent of the active modulus. The next question is whether the cross-linking actually affects the biomolecular mobilization. And here are our ratios 1, 4, and 5, and these are also statistically significantly different than our new UV control. So, no. Cross-linking